How's it going, everybody? This is Beat the Bush. Today, I'm going to talk about cashback credit cards and what you can do to extract the most value from credit cards. This is more like a very high-level view of how you should approach getting cashback on these credit cards. The first thing you have to know before jumping into all this is, are you a responsible credit card user? That is, you can only benefit from all this if you're the type of person that pays off all their credit cards, you don't have any credit card debt. When you're spending money to get all this cash back, you're not actually spending more money in order to get that cash back. So suffice to say, you have to be a very responsible credit card user. You might need to have a really high credit score in order to take advantage of all these cashback opportunities. Now, let me show you my little cheat sheet that I keep with me all the time, and I update this every single quarter. Now, the strategy for all of this is very simple. You may not have every single credit card on this, but whatever combination that you have, just find out the categories at which you get the highest cash back, put it all on the cheat sheet, and then make sure whenever you go out to spend on whatever categories that you pull out that particular credit card. I totally understand if your credit score is not high enough in order to get, let's say, a Chase Freedom credit card, you may not have this at your disposal. So whatever combination of credit card you have, you just have to go, okay, my highest percentage cash back that I can get for groceries is whatever card that is. And then you just put it all on a cheat sheet. You might be able to use an app or something, but I prefer to have like a little piece of paper just in case my phone runs out of battery. And it's just very handy to have it next to all my credit cards because that's where all my credit cards are and I can just reference it with one motion taking out of my wallet and then it's right there. It's the beginning of January right now. That's why I remade this little thing. So one of the major categories is probably going to buy gasoline. I now have an electric car, so all those categories is irrelevant to me. I cannot go to the gas station anymore, even if I wanted to. Although I still have a small scooter that is gasoline powered, but it takes so little gasoline, like half a gallon every time I fill up. So it doesn't really, factor in into anything. Another important category is groceries from Discover It this quarter. They happen to have it at Walgreens and CVS. This is 5%, by the way. And if you happen to be a first year card member of Discover, you can actually double this discount. So actually this quarter is 10% back on groceries. This is really, really good. This is up to $1,500. And if you happen to not spend $500 every single month on groceries, you can fill the rest up by buying gift cards at whatever place that you want. Let's say Amazon. Q1 of 2020, there's also Chase Freedom, which is gas, internet, cable, phone, streaming services. The only thing I personally need is internet, but then the amount in there is so little that it is almost not worth the effort because my internet bill is $55 right now. 5% on that is maybe $3, but I have to go into my AT&T account and just change the credit card numbers or something. Maybe I'll do it, maybe not, but it's just a small benefit over there if you have the time to do it. One of the major categories is also restaurants. I still have the Uber card. They did not convert this into a Uber points only yet. They're gonna do it for most card members before the middle of 2020. So while you are still on this actual cash back thing and it still has 4% on restaurants, use it while the getting is good, right? This is my mentality for most of the time. A lot of people just go, oh my gosh, it's changing. You worry about it, just use whatever that you have at your disposable today and then just, whatever happens, happens. And then whenever something does happen, then you can just rehash your cheat sheet to whatever advantage that you can get. One other strategy that I have to talk about, and I'm sorry, I'm talking about these credit cards that you can no longer get, such as the Ink card, which I get personally 3% off of restaurant, gas, office supplies, hardware, home improvement store. They kind of change these categories around. I have a lot of these grandfathered credit cards. The Uber one is sort of like a grandfathered credit card because you can no longer get the cash back. It's been about 3 months since I had this Uber card. The initial offer is if you spend $500, you get $100 cash back, not Uber credits, but actual cash. 3 months later, you can see I spend $548.54. Now the trick here is that I mostly only spent this $548 only on restaurants And I did not go out of my way to spend more on restaurants. It took me 3 months to spend this amount. Now, 4% on $500 is about $20. That's why you see here a cash redemption of $121.33. So getting $121 by spending $548 or so, this works out to be about a 22% discount. Basically, on any restaurant that I ever wanted to, I'm not restricted to eating at any particular place. I just spent it as I felt the need to. Now you see how advantageous this is when you play this credit card cashback game. I also have the Sears credit card. The interesting thing I want to talk about in this particular credit card is they don't have this offer all the time. I talk about getting 10% cashback on gas, groceries, and restaurants on this Sears card. But right now, I actually don't get anything. But I am anticipating they might send me a targeted offer. So I'm actually not using the credit card and waiting until they send me this targeted offer. If they do, then I'm gonna take this credit card and then go, okay, finally, now I have this targeted offer. Then I can go to the grocery stores, buy a whole bunch of gift cards and stuff, and then just meet their requirements and then get the cash back, which is between 10 and 25% even. So just to give you an idea, in December, I spent $750. Most of it is buying gift cards. I got $100 bonus cash back on it, and automatically I also get $150 cash back. So this is roughly 33% right there. This is a special targeted offer, but I thought I'd just kind of go over it anyway to just make you guys realize that there are these things out there. And when you are in this cashback game for a really long time, yeah, you're gonna get more and more of these credit cards that have a really good deal that no one else can get. It just gets grandfathered in. I'm also using a US Bank Cash Plus credit card. You choose the categories every single month, and I chose electronics and utilities because I can prepay my utilities. And also, if I buy electronics from some electronics store, I'm thinking maybe I get a GoPro, I'm gonna get 5% off cash back on this. There's a BBVA Compass card. I travel with this card, 3% on airfare, hotels, and stuff. Target card, I keep this card around 5% right off top. It's not a cash back. So whenever you buy anything with a Target card, let's say it's $100, you only pay $95 right then and there at the checkout stand. Bank of America Better Balance card, I always just use it once every single quarter. And then I usually charge such a low amount, maybe a dollar or something, and then I get $30 cash back every single quarter. And I usually just use this to buy groceries, you know, buy $30-$35 worth of groceries. And you know, that's just free groceries. And then the Capital One card, no foreign transaction fee, and I get 1.5%. This is like my fallback when I wanna use a card with no foreign transaction fee. Usually I use this card internationally. So that's all there is to this credit card cashback game. It's very, very simple. You're not gonna get every single card that I am able to get, but you certainly can start trying to collect them. But I'm saying, don't even start doing this unless you are a very responsible credit card user. You pay off everything every single month. And also watch out for buying too many gift cards, because if you don't have the discipline to not spend the gift card and think that it's free money. I personally have this issue sometimes when I have, you know, $1,000 worth of Amazon gift cards. After you have these gift cards for about a month or so, you kind of, the pain went away. The gift card amount is kind of like stored in your account, and then there's no pain to using it because you already paid for it. Does this make sense? Like, you already took money out of your checking account and paid for the credit card bill. And when this, let's say $500 gift card to Best Buy, to Amazon or something, has been sitting there for several months, you start to think that it's free, because when you go and spend it, it almost feels like it's free money, even though you know you paid for it yourself. So this is something I personally am watching out for, and I have to go, okay, you know, this money, I paid for it at some point. This is just something that you have to be very aware of so you don't just go around spending all your gift cards like it's free money. Thanks for watching this video, everybody. I hope this update really helps you guys out on how to get the most cash back from these credit cards. Don't forget to give me a like on this video, comment down below. Let me know if any of you guys have this Sears cashback credit card, because I talk about it all the time and it seems like no one else have it. Am I the only one over here? And as always, don't forget to push that subscribe button and ring that bell icon. Thanks for watching.